We were hoping that balloon would crash into the Clifton suspension bridge, but it let us down. We're in Redcliffe. Well, we're going to go into Redcliffe Cajun Bristol Sea. We're in the car at the moment.
As you can notice, we are wearing pirate hats at request of Beyond the Grave.
Yes, to stir up some ghosts because there's smugglers down here. And we never say no to dressing up. So the mine workings from 15th to 18th century that extend under the Redcliffe area of Bristol. The full extent of the caves isn't actually known. The caves are made of sandstone, so the sand was perfect for making glass. Bristol was the largest glass-making centre outside of London. So bottles for beers and spirits were produced, and it was also used for ships' ballasts. What is a ballast?
No one would know.
Do you want to ring her?
Goods for African and West Indian trade were stored in the caves, and there were many myths about the caves being used for smuggling and hidden treasure. And there's like a barred section of the caves where apparently slaves were kept. The Axbridge Caving Group, who discovered artifacts in their digs, like a scoop used for filling canvas.
Okay, this changes the history of the caves. You might actually get some ghosts.
At the lead shot tower, there was a small crucible for pouring molten lead, broken pottery, an ink pouring bottle and old clay pipes. And there's also chambers with... What was that? Writing
Missile.
On the walls. From like 1761. It's a genuine...
You've got a scoop in your hat.
Occasionally used to store slaves before they were sold in Bristol. And there were also rumours of French sailors being kept there as... prisoners of war during the French Revolution and Napoleonic Wars. The caves are used to store goods for the ships in the port. On the wall above one of the entrances is a plaque which talks about the middle passage.
So not the back passage.
That's just Phoebe Gray. She loves a good back passage.
Real or other side paranormal research, who spent 4 hours in the caves and they didn't actually record or feel anything. Second World War, a small section of the caves were used as a air raid shelter. Blackbeard is thought to have a hideaway cave under St. Mary's, which is the church. There doesn't seem to be many ghost stories linked to the caves. There are paranormal links, a show being human, which has a vampire, werewolf and a ghost.
Nobody cares.
Everyone cares. was filmed in season 2 episode 3. A 16th century witch trial was filmed there, and the vampire Mitchell took fellow vampire Cara into the caves to punish her for killing two children. We were excited about that bit. Huge being human fans.
I've replaced crisps with chocolate.
Throw into her hat.
If anyone annoys us on the tour, we can make our own ghost stories.
Yeah. Run off and get lost.
That's generally our plan.
Amazing, they let you guys keep coming back.
Extreme close up. Whoa.
Whoa.
Whoa. Whoa. Whoa.
Crash them.
Give us your best pirate speak.
Show us your booty.
I've all things to say to you, Kat.
If you're after my money, you should know me better than that. You should know I haven't got any.
I'm just hanging by the ankle.
Like a car fed over the railings. There we go.
Did you trip?
No, but I shouldn't have told her. She would have tripped.
Are you excited?
I am so excited.
What are you hoping to find down the cave?
Smugglers or the French prisoners or skeletons.
We got an Elio.
We won't be using it, but you two can use our crystals.
Yeah, you two are dead.
My battery's lost 10 minutes.
Right, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Alan. As I said before, I've been giving guided tours of Redcliffe Caves now for over...
Nothing happened.
I've been giving guided tours now of Redcliffe Caves now for 17 years, and tonight is my 556 tour. So I know... I'm going to walk you around the areas of the caves so you'll get an idea of the layout, so you shouldn't get lost. If you do get lost, I'll do a sweep up at the end and check out for any bodies. There's rumours they stretch up to Clifton and over to Knowle. I'm a caver. I'd love that to be true. Just an acre of caves left here now. But 400 feet beneath our feet are the tunnels from the Bedminster coal mines. So we've got caves on top of mines. But tonight you'll be seeing no caves at all. These were also dug out by man, probably between the year 1650 to 1750. And opposite Redcliffe Roundabout, there's a small little park. It's the Friends Burial Grounds, the Friends for the Quakers. But at the back of the park, there's a small little doorway. In 1346, Lord Thomas Berkeley of Gloucestershire paid for a hermit called John Spratt to sit in this part of the caves and pray for him and his family. The first reference to Redcliffe Caves, 1346. And from that date right through to 1660, a succession of hermits sat in that part of the caves and prayed for their benefactors. Bristol was quite devastated during the Second World War, and the worst raid to hit Redcliffe was a Good Friday raid, April 11th, 1941. There were 153 German planes, they dropped 193 tons of high explosive, 36,000 incendiaries, 5 bombmen were shot down and 180 people were killed. The raid lasted more than 5 hours. It was the last major major raid on Bristol.
It's 11 days, so it's the anniversary. The bombs.
We're going to go up here, have a look at that shaft, and then here, have a look at some formations and some carvings. Round here, round this way, another shaft here, tree roots here, back here
see
the train
pen,
round that way see the main chamber, past the foundations
to
the Southern Light
Sockets
Block, which is now the
Mercury Hotel. It's inconvenient what they check them.
It was in his text that wasn't.
Then you'll be relieved of me.
I shall not be relieving him.
I take the guided tours into, but it's a bit lower, a bit more complicated. So this way is blocked off for you. And from this down here is mostly crawly, stuff about so high and quite muddy, and that leads you to the railway tunnel that cuts through the caves. This used to be the entrance to the caves. And up until about 10 years ago, there used to be a very tired old oak door here. Vandals got into the caves and kicked it in. The ceiling has been painted white, it's been lime washed. There's 7 of these bricked up windows, you can see at the end there. And if you look at them from the outside, they're like the arrow slits you see on castle. So painting it white will reflect a tiny bit of light in here. When you go under here, have a look up. This is a shaft that goes up to the surface. Remains of a narrow gauge railway in the cobblestones. And on an 1888 map, one leg of it does a sharp right-hand turn and goes over to the wooden hut where we were. Other leg of it goes right to the very end of the wharf where the wooden crane still stands. And these railway tracks are buried here underneath the floor. We used a metal detector and they finish at the shaft. My theory says that the boat owners will offload their goods into little hand carts, push the goods into the cave, store the goods into the caves, and when they were sold, they'd be taken up this shaft here to the surface.
Looking at the shaft.
You can see it up there now.
When I first came into the caves, I thought there'd be carvings and writing on the wall everywhere, but there's very, very little. This Victorian turnover collar shirt, and he's wearing a gigantic tailcoat. But look, he's carved underneath the lime wash. So I'm sure he's quite old and quite genuine. In 1868, when the Midland Railway Company put the railway tunnel through the caves, he also purchased Phoenix Wharf and Redcliffe Wharf, and they used the wharfs and the caves for storage. And being railway engineers, they came in to inspect their new property, the caves. They were horrified when they saw these cracks and fissures in the roof. That's why I'm stood here. They built these railway arches in the vulnerable places. These are straw stalactites. The rainfall falls on the car park above, slowly percolates through the 18 feet of red sandstone, and then the water comes to this railway arch. And as the water slowly filters through the concrete, it picks up a mineral called gypsum. And as each drip drips off, gradually these straws grow, and they're hollow. And the water runs through the center of the straw. And when the drip drips on the floor, you get the stalagmites starting to grow. This is the area that they've called the Hermitage, because through that slot in the wall there leads you to about 10 foot from the Hermitage.
I found myself a hermit. He's dressed as a pirate. Lives in a summer house rather than a cave.
Should we try you later?
Boost me up, I'll get in there.
It's going to be so cool. We'll just lose everything and just like go off and hide.
Welcome to Redcliffe Beach. We've got a lovely sandy beach here. You've only filmed 3 episodes of Casualty in here, 3 episodes of Being Human, an episode of Skins, Aquila, a children's programme about the spaceship in the caves, Most Haunted Life. And I was involved with this.
Get out.
And I came in with the medium. I was told not to tell him anything at all. And so we were walking around the caves, him and I, in pure silence. Then he said to me, how many times should you be down here? I said, well, I've done about 400 guided tours and about 50 or 60 times all by myself. He said, have you seen anything? Have you heard anything? No, I said. And they found loads of ghosts here. One even pulled the star of the show along a passageway by his legs. On one of the shoots they wanted to do for the Famous Five, they wanted to use this shaft here that goes up to the surface. And they weren't happy with the lip of the shaft. See, it's made of polystyrene.
Yeah.
These are the old tap roots of the tree that were coming through. Now
nice.
Broken.
I look really creepy night vision. I like it. Hi-ho!
Hi-ho! Hi-ho! It does look like you're drawing. It's you too. Yeah. What's going on? What's coming out of your bellies?
Alien.
Alien twins.
Links.
There's Cat. To my left and right are Neolithic cave paintings, 10,000 years old. No. Even the scouts and cubs don't believe me. No, these date back to November 1997, and outside the caves it's night time, and it's absolutely tipping down with rain. And I'm driving across the wharf to come and explore the caves. My headlights spot these two figures disappearing into the caves. They're both men, and they're both so high, and both wearing long, jet-black wigs down to their waist. They're both naked. Apart from that, each wearing a tiny little loincloth. And I come into the caves, and they're here, in front of the paintings. And in the centre here's a fire, and they're dancing round and round and round the fire, singing and chanting in very strange voices. Not quite as strange as it sounds. They were actors. They were in here filming South American religious cave rituals. It was a series of 4 programmes on the BBC called Spirit of the Jaguar.
You need to duck it for that. Actually, you do a little bit. I'm disappointed.
Okay, I can't fit that.
Yeah. She's like a normal sized person now. So fat. I can't believe
she's built enough
of that.
Yeah, still room.
This dates back to 1542.
It seems so archaic.
And this dates back to 1983. 83. How old are you?
83. Another relic from 83.
There's a few man-made walls.
We missed it.
Right turn, crawl for 15 feet, left turn, crawl for another 15 feet. You come to 3 chambers. And the last chamber is packed with writing. People's names, initials, funny symbols, and the dates on there range from 1761 to 1789, which I believe is the age of the caves that we use, people use to store
food. Descent, but in that tunnel there.
I have actually no idea where we are.
No. So this is going
to be totally going to get lost.
We could leave like crumbs because we don't like those chocolate biscuits, but I've eaten them, so I don't want to do that.
JL.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Before I dye it again.
Yeah.
Oh, my grey hair.
30 years old and grey, 31, not a single grey hair. It went wrong.
Yeah, this is meant to be turquoise.
It's yeah. turquoise at the top.
See mine's turquoise.
Oh yeah,
it's turquoise at the top.
That's why you're wearing the hat. The bad dye job.
The thing is, the green faded so much it went yellow. So then we put a turquoise in, it went green.
Got a circuit board. Lucky I'm wearing gloves so my rings won't activate and set it off.
Battery level is low. It had 15 minutes on it.
This is a new battery.
And we have lost your mum already.
Mum's just joined us. She comes down the case with us, she's already bugged off and already embarrassed by Cammy. Rather walk with strangers.
It's one of those teddies that's got stuff in it so it'll light up when someone comes near it.
Evil teddy. Yeah. Evil.
EMF teddy. And we are loud. We're not shot. Creepy, creepy alien type creature. Creepy, like that teddy bear.
Any phantom farting? Can you say so that when I'm listening back in the week? Seriously now, I know.
Rather than it thinking it's paranormal, it's just your arse. What everybody know, don't imagine, okay, a ball of white light above your head, okay? Don't imagine the white light now is pushing out of this ball down to the top of your head. I want you to pull the white light down through your face, down through your neck, over your shoulders, and down through your arms. Pull it down through your chest, through your stomach. Okay, down through your legs. I want you to push it deep into the floor. Imagine this white light is like a shower, pumping all this white energy down through your body. Imagine pushing the white light out. You fill in the whole space, the whole caves with the white light. I want you to imagine forcing it down your left arm. Okay, push it up the right arm of the person next to you. And you will receive it up your right arm from the person to your right. Any spirits in this area we are now would like to come forward, please, and let themselves be known, either through touching someone, affecting the lights on the floor, turning the torch on, up to the red light in the corner, or throwing something. A spirit of a little girl in here before, the name is Mary. Right, I've seen a flash of light on the floor behind me. Look.
There's a bear on the table if you want to touch it.
Make someone feel sad, happy, make them feel angry, make them feel sick.
Spirits of the Lady of the Night in here, as if you are, make the light. Awesome,
called Mary.
Let's just know that you're here by making the lights go on or making the lights at the back go on.
I've got freezing cold now in the back. Is anybody else feeling anything at all?
It was like something
crazy down the floor. Oh, was there
like a little movement, was it? No, it was like something going then. Yeah, Max feeling sick and he feels like there's someone pushing on his shoulders. Okay. Alright, take the sickness off Mac then. Give it to somebody else. Well, thanks for pushing his shoulders. And just push him forward.
The spirit of the little girl is here. Could you put back the burning and fall or just touch the hand on the sheet and it will go off, please?
Okay.
All we've got to do is touch it and it will go off, make a noise. It won't hear you.
Make some of the lights on the floor go up to orange. Pinching my back. Somebody's pinching your back.
Like, do you know when someone digs a nail in?
Yeah.
Like,
okay.
Is there anything for me to go up and come?
No, I can't see anything.
What's that?
She's getting pulled to the back.
Who?
Right.
Somebody just
tickled
my hair.
Right, can you keep walking around the circle and doing things to people, please? Mark, you feeling all right now?
Is somebody walking around the circle? Because I thought your dad just walked past me and he stood by the side of me. I seen somebody walking behind me. Is somebody walking around the circle?
Somebody touched my hair just now.
Philippe? It's like you're walking around a circle. Or if it's Mary, you don't particularly like women being in this spot. Can you tug on one of Gwen's hair, please?
Somebody, let go of the guy on the wall.
Yeah. Mary, are you behind us, Mary?
If I throw this, can you throw it back? Can you throw it? Can anyone speak French?
Bonjour, ça va?
It's not friendly.
He felt a bit hot all of a sudden after I asked him how he was.
Can you ask him if he, if he was in a fire or didn't get burned?
Nous ne vous voulons pas qu'on meure.
Who's that?
Yeah, there was a
crow. Was that a
crow? Yeah. I heard a
Y a-t-il un spirit ici?
Throw your hands now if you want. Unless you particularly like one.
Your hand warmed up eventually.
I know.
But this one
is
too much. Your hand really
helps. Does anybody like to speak to us? Any spirits through this box? Use the white noise. Could you tell us your name?
Well, come forward now.
Would you like to communicate with us? You're walking behind the circle.
Is somebody walking then?
Yeah, I was just stepping.
Oh, okay. You're looking forward to the footstep then?
Yeah, I've got very small feet.
If you're angry with us for being here, show us how angry you are. Do something to get us out. Throw something. Knock something over. Make a loud noise or show yourself in light form. When you hear your footsteps from down in the cave.
If we all sit up there.
It's cold here. I'm on the same side as I was getting the pain.
This arm is 19 degrees.
But this arm, to be honest, 28 degrees. The coldness is gone. So. What about my toes? My toes are freezing!
My toes are cold, that's why I got my baby boots on. 13 degrees on the toes.
Go!
Boots are full on your back.
Hot step, what can I say?
Where should we go, people?
Somewhere where there's no
one
to go.
Anywhere.
Good job! I think we found a secluded bit.
Ah!
I fell down there.
Ooh, look at the cavern in the back.
There's a hole.
Ah! Oh, cool.
Hang on, we've lost your man. We've up here.
Okay, so I think we've managed to break away from the group.
This is like hobbit-sized bubbles now.
I don't think we're supposed to be in here.
Welcome to Calamityville!
There's an arrow
and then something 90. 1790. If you look down here, there's white rocks. Somebody's probably just picked these up and drawn on it. We are measuring at 9 degrees in this part of the cavern.
When we were in the circle, Mum was getting the name Albert.
Right, okay.
She tried to communicate, didn't we?
Really, really, really cold. Desperately cold.
When the name came through?
Yeah.
Albert, can you give us a yes? Can you give us a no? You're not trying very hard, Albert.
Big cross.
Oop.
It's coming back on itself.
Spinning.
Now.
In.
Are you asking any questions at the moment? Are you just walking around?
No, I'm just walking around.
Is there anyone in the
universe? Gone back. Oh, now it's gone the other way.
Those are voices from people further down the cave.
Usher guns people.
Some of us are a serious show. Can you come and talk to the machine?
Come and make this K2 machine here. Try and make it go to red.
We have a circuit board. You can make that light up by putting your energy between the two metal prongs.
See it light up? Can you do it too? Can you make it light up? Can
you throw a stone. There's plenty of them in here.
Are you one of the slaves that were potentially held here?
I'm getting that suppressed feeling on my chest again. I was getting it when we were in the circle, that my breathing was laboured.
Fine when we were walking around, yeah. When we were settling.
Yeah, but if you work down here all the time.
Spirits, if that's you pushing Undine's chest, can you poke her?
Are you perhaps one of the French prisoners that was here?
Allez-vous en anglais? Because none of us speak French.
Our French is so bad we got kicked out of our GCSE class.
Can stretch as far as Venafort.
Sent the pain right to my back now.
From the chest?
From my chest. Perhaps he had a heart attack.
Scan her, where's the K2?
It's really deep inside. You're dead.
Are you putting your ailments on, Janine?
Don't say my real name. How very dare you? On camera!
Sign the light and fighting them to think in the shadow. Clarity Bill, ever professional testing their equipment before an event? Like no. I mean, what kind of unprofessional jokers would bring a camera to an event they've never used, they never even practiced with, and then use it on the
use it on the first time in the dark. I know.
Pick me.
Did you hear it like being musical at one point? I'd accidentally pressed pause and then couldn't get it to record again.
Sorry. Wait. Hang on. Damn it. Sorry. That's
an unprofessional. Some people.
What have you done now?
Well, I actually switched on the DVR and then when I tried to shut off, the K2 went off.
I can't actually focus on you at all.
It's not how far people are away, the acoustics down the cave are going to bring their voices to us. Mm. So if you catch any voices on the DVR, we don't know whether it's the people. So.
Are you connecting with anyone, Mum?
No.
Rubbish. We bring her along and she's no good. She's broken.
We've got an Albert.
Yes.
Is Albert with us now? Move the rods, Albert. Show us you're here. Is anyone else with us here? How about Mary? Or Thomas?
The ghosts don't tend to like Calamity
Village.
I don't think many people like Calamity Village in general.
Which way should we go? Don't tell me which way to go,
but
I'm walking into the wall.
You maybe that's the idea.
Left one's gone, Janine.
This is very Blair Witch now.
It wants you to stand against the wall.
Yeah.
Alright, so Mum, you stay there and we'll go on.
Why are you taking us to this column? Are you buried inside it? Have you hidden treasure in here? Where's the skull cave?
Perhaps they want me to go that way.
Okay, follow it.
Let's go this way. Right, so which way do we go now? Do you want to go this way?
Going that way.
Follow the rods.
They don't hurt.
Forget if I know which way is the entrance.
We just going to go under this side.
This way.
But I think that's really, we just walked.
Do you mean you've just gone in circles?
Yeah.
We've just gone in a circle. But go this way.
I think the main entrance is back
this way.
Yeah. Just let the rods lead us and we'll follow them.
Where did we come from?
I got no idea.
Did she go
that? There's a plant. Yeah, is this the one or does she mean the one?
Oh,
We've lost our peoples.
Hello?
Oh, there you are. Did you stop to take a photo?
Yeah. Is there anyone here?
Any children here that want to communicate with us? Come and play with us. I've got such stubby fingers.
Sorry, it's 11 degrees. Are there any French prisoners down here? Calamity will feel very unloved.
Nobody's ever come to talk to us.
No. We're like the unpopular kids in school. We were the
unpopular kids in school.
Are you female?
Are you male?
Can you read?
If you can't spell your name, see this X? You can use this X. Like you would if you signed in your name if you were...
Literate.
That's it. I was going to say legitimate now, but no, it's not legitimate. Yeah, literate. Which I clearly am at the moment.
Can you move this?
Right.
This word here says hello.
Oh.
I thought it said help.
Hello. Can you move the planchette to here? Say hello to us.
Do you want us down here with you? Making you perform like a seal.
You can poke somebody, pull their hair.
Steal Lynx's hat.
You just want me to have hat head on camera. If you don't want to talk to us, move the planchette to no.
This is no.
Which way? Did you get
those in? Not a sausage!
You said that last time!
Still no sausages.
That's because you're asking for sausage. Vegetarian.
Believe me, I never ask for sausage.
Thomas, are you here? Because you're usually at this table, aren't you? You going to talk to the girls?
Tried Thomas. He just doesn't like pirates, I don't think. That's the problem. Why? We these two.
I know. I said to Darren, I'm going to actually ask the girls to come in their burlesque. And see if they can challenge Mary the prosy.
Well, that's halfway
there. She's halfway there. Yeah. I know.
Didn't you wear that to burlesque?
She
did.
Did.
One of you did.
Is there a prostitute here? We're often accused of dressing like prostitutes. Come on, smugglers. We're dressed like you. We want to help.
Especially if it's gold.
It moved a bit then.
Come on, smugglers. We want to share in your go.
Is there a planchette?
That was me. Typical calamity though, really. Nothing ever happens when we're around.
Make it later.
You're being led this way.
You're led this way at all.
Are you bringing anything with you? Because we've got nothing. They seem to like you.
Whoa. This is going nuts.
Is that it? Let me see. Oh, yeah.
Is there anybody here with us now? Would like to communicate with us?
You following me?
This one is a red.
Move slightly, push it again.
Come on, Spirit, are you following these two? Because you don't seem to like us very much.
Show us some love, Spirits, come on.
Two orange flashing.
It's over there.
You're making our lights flash.
Come and make this one flash over here.
This orange, when I first got here, it was going into the red, it hasn't gone into the red yet.
Whereas this needle, no, our needle hasn't moved at all.
Prostitutes. This prostitute is bound to be children.
Make the bulb flash, we'll be very impressed.
Good shot, actually.
Touching me.
Yeah.
Yeah, checking you.
Me and stop groping. It's not that kind
this
of tour.
Oh, not like the Stratford one.
You should try to see if you can switch that one with someone else to see if it's the actual meter.
Dead.
Light up to red if you want us to bugger off.
Struck.
Are you a girl?
I can
just see a pair of fingers over there.
Ghosty fingers.
There's a pair of fingers on the camera and I couldn't see anyone else.
You mark us.
Who's Marcus?
He's probably tired past his bedtime.
Yeah. Are you tired?
Maybe.
Yeah, oh, that really went up.
It's right in the middle of the.
We keeping you up?
Yes.
Ooh. What do I go to then?
Top orange.
We won't be here all night.
Do you want us to leave you?
Yep.
Can you push somebody? Do you want to hurt anybody?
Play fun.
Do you want to play games?
Yeah, see if you can get this to be, because this will be in flash red to be that one.
And you turned that alarm off earlier. Thank you for doing it. We just need you to do a little bit more for us, please. Like something just touched my elbow. The inside, not my elbow, sorry.
The
other side.
The opposite bit of your elbow.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right. Freezing.
Your left arm's freezing.
Okay.
Oh, there was a tickle on my thigh. Oh, you've got a tickly thigh as well.
It's inside.
Oh. If that was you, Pokanine, thank you.
Great. Well, Max just had his thigh broke as well. Mm-hmm. You're a bit of a groper, can I have a bit?
Do it right the way around the circle.
If there's a spirit of a Romany person here or a Tinga here, could you let us know by changing the colours of the lights on the floor or putting a light on somebody in the circle?
Take this cave darker for us.
That was a whistle?
Yeah, it was a whistle.
Something was moving again behind us here.
Can you do it again?
Between you and me.
I just heard singing.
We've had that in this.
Really, really faint. It's
really faint,
like,
and
kids.
It comes from down the other. Yes, it is children. It's like nursery rhymes.
Yeah. It's really, really faint.
Was that something down from.
That was behind us.
It was, wasn't it?
What was that?
Yeah, I heard that.
What,
it was
what?
Like. Is it this shuffling or something of the foot?
Tapping.
Is it tapping?
You two have got a woman in between you. She's quite far back. White figure.
The lady who's standing behind Alan and Vicky. Would you like to come forward? Or let them know, maybe you can touch Alan, you'll know Alan, because he's always down here. You just flick him in the back of the head, so you're not a disbeliever.
Literally right behind you, Vicky. Your head is on your shoulder.
A name? What's your name?
Right, did you see that?
Yeah.
She just ran her fingers down Alan's shoulder. Do you feel anything? I just seen her hand go down your arm.
Did you see that in the dark?
No.
She's in between you, but still there.
Did somebody just see somebody walking down there?
Yeah, I just
walked
in.
I shouted. I shouted.
Bruce, go ahead.
There you go.
Yeah.
See?
Just that everything hits on the opposite side to where we are.
As I walked down, I seen somebody walking in between the one pillar and walk behind the other. There was something down that corridor, right down where I walked down there. So I've just seen
a shape of a man down there behind.
Right.
And he just disappeared.
We're on the wrong side of the bloody circle again.
We've got two girls here with their tricorn hats. Is that something you used to wear? Should they be worn by women? Knock their hat off if you don't like them wearing them.
I'm banning you from wearing PVC on these bloody things.
Take the energy from the circle.
Did you catch what happened?
She touched you, you catch yourself, and you jumped.
Hello?
Yeah, I'm getting my pinkies on my head.
Someone pinched my chimneys. Yeah, I felt like tickling
you
quite
hard. You know, when somebody comes close to me, I move like that on your side.
And I'm very ticklish, and I've got my friend's hand in my hand, so it's not her this time.
Set that alarm off again for me, please.
I'm just going over here.
Right, a flash of light in that corner there then. Did you see it? Yeah.
To the right, to the doorway, there's There is a face behind you. It's glowing.
Yeah, there's someone stood there.
No, it's not.
just touch. It. Yeah, right.
Don't say that.
Well, so in the dark. Touched, have you?
No, we're touching each other, but not in that way.
Just seen a little boy between Alan and Pearson, to his left, and he just whistled.
Both your backs gone, crippled people.
My back is gone, yeah. It's killing me. That's right down my arm, into my chest, and above my neck. Did you see anything? Or
nope.
Anything
nope. Though? Nothing. Please. Would you like my eyes patched?
No, it's fine. How about you? Not a fish finger. You know, once I've used the patch, it'll be okay. It's just standing still.
Is anyone here? Can you give me a straight line for yes or a circle for no? Come on, she just wants to talk. Is there an Elizabeth here? You stand between Alan and Vicky. Is your name Mary?
How old are you, Mary?
Remind you of something.
Come over
sorry,
here.
But I'm
I feel like I'm running around the cave. It's just a warm up.
If you go in the dark, you'll trip and then I'll catch it.
Oh, yeah, you'd love that.
I would love that. Where do you want to go? No idea. There's some
Maria. Are there any ghosties
around here? Hello. Wow. It's got really cold
in
here.
It's bloody freezing.
Degrees.
Yeah. It definitely feels colder than that.
So we in a corner right now.
Yeah.
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 But
you don't want to come out of here.
Come on,
we've got
to
go. Didn't you just come from down?
Well, I don't know.
I'm sure we just came from down there. I don't know. Yeah, we did. We came from down.
Are you sure?
Yeah, but we came from, like, round this side of it. Oh, and we just passed there.
Maybe the caves just aren't that big.
I think we can just actually go around.
I wanted to see Kenneth come through it.
I could get through it easily.
Up to him! We can go around somehow. What?
Let's go!
Which way are we going?
Oh, hang on.
No.
Oh,
penis. So we're by the drawer then.
It's that red candle again. It's following us.
We're on the navigator.
Lost.
So you shouldn't get lost.
The one person who has any hope of getting us out of anywhere.
Lost.
Lost.
We're just going to keep walking around.
What's yours like? Is yours going next? No, nothing.
Oh,
it's cold down here, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really cold all of a sudden.
Have you ever seen it? Have you seen anything at all in your 2 summers?
Not when I go to Hanscape, when we're actually looking at Dominic. Oh, well, it's fun anyway.
Come on, can make him light up by myself.
It's you, you're sitting
there. Camera.
Cat is setting off the K2 music.
Pat is haunted.
No.
What have you got to say for yourself?
I'm not ashamed.
It's strange because she's
probably dead on the inside. Do you want to turn into an energy from this?
I'm not going to get any from Cat. No, she's just full of Red Bull.
Are we by the entrance?
Yes.
I'm so lost.
You always are.
Back for the final part.
See this bit? We could have stood in the warm for the
last. Ah, what are we? Gates open, check on people. Oh, God.
I'll film this one. I'll film it on here, so I'm not holding your cameras
too. Do you not want to buff up your arms with this?
My arms ache.
Your arms ache? We have a trigger object. Which way? Cat!
Right, jingle balls.
Come on, you two, get that energy flowing through your veins.
Yeah, you've got to
do some star jumps. Get rid of energy.
Hey!
My phone's just turned on the box. Can you turn it back off, though? Is that good for doing that? Can you stop it now?
No, please don't. Let's get the exercise.
What was that?
That
came from
a sneezing or coughing or something from Daniel Brent. Or...
Thank you very much if that was your voice. Can you make it a bit louder, please? Again.
There's people down there.
Yeah, I can see a light. I can see a light from this
monitor. We've been asked now by someone to call out for a man named Bert. His name might actually be Albert. So ask you turning the light on at the bottom. Can you do it again for me, please?
Incredible
pain in my left ear.
Oh, that's
an awful noise. I'm scared the life out of
you. Sorry.
Anyone feeling spooked yet?
No,
sorry.
There is nothing happening today. I can conclude Redcliffe Caves is not haunted.
Yeah,
Do you concur?
I concur.
Well, we knew that before we came.
We just wanted to play down some dark caves for the night.
We don't want to play in some dark caves.
Zoe. Is the answer to that one?
So, have you enjoyed your first experience with Canyon?
I certainly have.
Would you come back again?
I certainly would.
Would we invite her again?
Of course.
You're too polite.
Who told Albert?
He mentioned Albert. You picked up on the Albert, and obviously someone else has picked up on the Albert as well, because that's not a name that you usually get.
No, but they may have overheard us.
Possibly, we're in a secluded part.
You're going to get lost going through again. I'm just going to go round in circles. Waiting for a Calamityville trip up. Is it the cameraman? Or is it going to be one of these?
Can you show yourself then in shadow form like you showed yourself so many tonight? Something moved there. Is Alan? Alan? Somebody moved behind you two then, in that archway.
Come on, Mary, there's plenty of men down here. You can make loads of money tonight. I'm sure there's more than one down here that's willing.
Did you hear the tapping then?
Yeah. So that's you further on down the tunnel. Can you make it clearer?
Yeah.
At the end of the chamber, it's bloody cold here.
It's 9 degrees then.
Stay at ours tonight, you
care? I don't know. I think they should maybe check the panels so we can stay the night to hide somewhere.
Oh, yes,
see, that'd be great, but I have work. I have to be up at 7:15. And I'm tired and my back hurts. My knees hurt and my shoulder hurts.
You know, keeping them locked in position.
It wouldn't be an episode of Calamityville without all the whinging and the moaning.
My knees started to hurt, but that's why I don't keep still. I flex it, I kick, I march on the spot. I do.
Like spooky lighting.
Yesterday, when we were at Redcliffe Cove, we missed most of the introduction that Beyond the Grey were doing because we were trying to figure out how to attach our IR light to his iPad, hence his name.
Show the people your iPad.
This morning, we made a discovery. Yeah, after spending pretty much most of the introduction, we missed because we were just messing around with it. Because we were like, well, how is this going to fit onto the screw arm of the bracket? We just had to stick it on top. But when you got like the Sony Handycam TRV that we were using last night, which is a heavy camera in itself, having then two extra lights on the back at either side, my God, my arms were aching. I'm going to have these like massive biceps and forearms just from holding up this camera. The brackets that actually came with the IR lights, screw underneath. We had the brackets with us because we wore the brackets because if we wanted to like just stand the IR light like up on itself, or like we knew that they could attach to the tripod. For some reason, being able to attach them to the tripod didn't quite compute to being able to attach them to a goddamn light bracket. After like the catastrophe of not being able to work out the camera in the dark, having never used it, and having actually didn't even know how to put the tape in because really hadn't tested that. The first time I actually put the tape in was putting the tape in before the investigation. And after like playing the spoofing, mockery of me and Nee. Parking meters 5, Calamityville 0 at the moment.
I seriously think that we need to switch our brains off and switch them back on again.
Like the cameras to save battery life.
Yeah. Say hello to the people, Pay.
Your first time on Calamityville.
And you have to be associated with us being jackasses. I know.
It's not the life you signed up for.
The witch burned here. They used to suspend them in chains and hang them up here to die. We're not convinced the house exists. This is what happens when we come on our own.